Now, how do we use this? Well, we take a function we've defined, say sec of x, y, and then we can say sequence is redefined as being the n-ary function of sequence. Oops, I guess I gotta fix this typo here. From now on, I can call sequence and pass it any number of numbers, and it will return the result that looks like that. So that looks good, and in fact, this pattern is so common in Python that there's a special notation for it. And the notation is called the decorator notation. It looks like this. All we have to do is say @, then the name of a function, and then the definition. And this is the same as saying sequence equals n-ary of sequence. It's just an easier way to write it. But there is one problem with the way we've specified this particular decorator, which is if I'm in an interactive session and I ask for help on sequence, I would like to see the argument list, and if there's a doc string, I want to see the documentation. Here I didn't happen to put in any documentation for sequence. But when I ask for help, what I get is this. I'm told that sequence is called n-ary function. Well, why is that? Because this is what we returned when we defined sequence equals n-ary of sequence. We return this thing that has the name n-ary function. And so we would like to fix n-ary up so that when the object that it returns has the same function name and the same function documentation, if there is any documentation, and have that copied over into the n-ary f function. Now, it turns out that there is a function to do exactly that. And so I'm going to go get it. I'm going to say from the functools, the functional tools package, I want to import the function called update wrapper. Update wrapper takes two functions and it copies over the function name and the documentation and several other stuff from the old function to the new function. And I can change n-ary to do that. So once I've defined the n-ary function, then I can go ahead and update the wrapper of the n-ary function, the thing I'm going to be returning from the old function. And so this will be the old sequence, which has a sequence name, a list of arguments, maybe some documentation string, and this will be the function that we're returning. We're copying over everything from f into n-ary f. And now, when I ask for help, when I define n-ary sequence, and I ask for help on sequence, what I'll see is the correct name for sequence, and if there was any documentation string for sequence, that would appear here as well. So update wrappers is a helpful tool. It helps us when we're debugging. It doesn't really help us in the execution of the program, but in doing debugging, it's really helpful to know what the correct names of your functions are. Notice that we may be violating the don't repeat yourself principle here. So this n-ary function is a decorator that I'm using in this form to update the definition of sequence. I had to, within my definition of n-ary, I had to write down that I want to update the wrapper. But it seems like I'm going to want to update the wrapper for every decorator, not just for n-ary. And I don't want to repeat myself on every decorator that I'm going to define.